fancy. Oh, you are state, no vacancy. Last time, see you on FaceTime, shutting up the place, bout you know my relationship. Me, I go put you on lockdown. I put your body on lockdown. You got me on lock now. You got my person on lock. Oh, if you love me, you should let me. You should let me. You should let me know. And if you don't know, better feel let me. Better feel let me. I better you let me go. Pulling up, pulling up, pulling up. Nobody deal with the bugger and talking. Me nothing know we are chilling in the apartment. Hope you don't mind me asking. Where will we go? When the quarantine thing done and everybody touch bro.
Headed to work with my boo. Yeah. And we got Miss Cimone in the back.
Hey, everybody.
And we are talking about our crazy adventures. So what was your question?
So my question was, like, how are you feeling about, like, the whole narrative, the whole, you know, you guys are packing up, you're leaving what you've known as your normal.
Yeah.
Right? And so you're starting on this new journey. So I just want to know, like, how you feeling? Like, are you feeling having some anxiety? What's going on back there? Up there?
Ooh, well, I naturally struggle with anxiety.
Okay.
So I have been slowly every day just kind of letting go of the house, sitting down. I have had days of crying. I have had days of, are we really doing this? woo! Yeah, we really doing this. But I've also had a lot of, we need to do this. We need to let go of this to receive more from the universe. So that's kind of pushing me to not be as sad as I could be, because it's for better opportunities, better adventure, just to live life. But it's scary as hell. Definitely hits the bottom of the stomach to purge, because we're getting rid of everything. Like, we're not, we're, all of our furniture is being sold. It really is just our clothes. So the purge and all of that, it's just so many levels to it. But excited and scared at the same time, which is, they say when you're really dreaming, if you're not scared, why you're not dreaming big enough. I'm hella scared. Never not had a foundation, because we had this home now for 14 years. And so this is going to be scary as hell. But yeah, so that's how I feel about it.
So, okay, you said something about, and that was something that I thought about, like, because you have to get rid of so much, right? You got to get rid of, like, all of the stuff that you have to get rid of. And I think, you know, we're naturally hang on to things, right? We get attached to things. This is my car. This is my dad. This is my ring. This is, you know.
Yeah, this belongs to me.
Right. And it's so let's, I got to know, how are you guys feeling about getting rid of, I mean, like, pretty much you guys are the royal nomads. I mean, you are going to literally have very few items,
right?
Because you're going from place to place. So, like you said, like, your clothes, and mind you, you're probably only keeping your favorites, because you don't even get a chance to tote everything.
No. And I love clothes. I love shoes. Okay.
Right, I'm saying, like, what is your...
Y'all, this has been a real serious process for her. I'm telling y'all, this has been a process for her. I know for me, I've never really been somebody big on things, so I know it's been a lot easier for me to detach from those things.
Yeah.
But I think that's also, you know, part of the blessing of us being together, because me having that, like, lack of attachment has been able to help me kind of coach everybody else to detach from that.
Okay.
and put things into a different perspective, because, you know, some people may look at lack of attachment as a, you know, oh, you don't care about something or you don't care about things. But I think it's just about where we place our value. And, you know, for me, I place value in different places. And so the experience is much more valuable than the thing. Mm-hmm. And I think that's the message that I've been trying to give to the kids, trying to get Tamieka to, you know, get behind. But even before we decided to sell the house and go on this, you know, journey, we started to kind of purge and start to try to live a little bit closer to like a more minimalist life, you know. Not, you know, we still had a lot of stuff that we wanted, but still had the stuff that the things and stuff that we wanted, but and we didn't really go to a full minimalist life, but it was for us trying to get down to more of the things we need and not just things that we wanted. And so we were already doing that in our house before we decided to sell, before we decided to go on this journey. And so once we decided to do it, everything just started to ramp up. And I noticed as I'm going through the process, you know, I have to kind of push the effort along, because again, for me, detaching from those things are not as difficult for me as it is for the rest of the family. So
I'm a hoarder.
Yeah. You know, she comes from a long line of hoarders.
I hoard things of emotional attachment.
We have her dresser that she had as a kid. I don't know how she's really gonna.
They don't even make furniture like they used to in the 80s. Okay, so.
But we have other stuff too, like the table I grew up eating at as a kid. The you know, that I got from my mom is the table we have in our house, and so we have to sell that now. You know, so wow. There's not just the 14 years of our memories, but you know, memories all the way back to when I was a kid. So. But, you know, you, like T said, you got to spend time, I think, really sitting with that and processing those thoughts, those emotions, those, you know, all of that, so that you can release it. You know, it's not that you release the memories and the feelings, but you release the thing, you know. Yeah. What I mean? And you grab hold of what is important about, you know, that thing, and you try to recreate that in other areas. So, like, if, for me, growing up, it was important having that table at our house, because I grew up eating dinner at that table every night with my family. Like, that was something that was a thing in my house. We had to eat dinner together. So giving my family that experience was important to me. They've had that. Mm-hmm. And so now we have to, you know, we continue that tradition, but it won't be at that particular table.
Okay. Well, I don't know. I mean, like I said, I think that this is the dopest thing, but it definitely takes a... Yeah. You know what? You know what's even bigger than this? So, somebody could do this, and they're single, or even a couple, right? So, being single, this would still be a great feat. Like, okay, cool, but I'm going to do my thing for a year, whatever. A couple doing it, that's a big thing. Because, okay, we're going to do this together, but we still have two different personalities. The amazing thing is that y'all taking three children along with you guys. So you have the two strong personalities and two, you know, or the two needs and wants of two adults, but still finding time to govern, police, love, and raise three children on this journey. Have y'all mapped out what this is going to look like?
That's a good question.
That's a great question.
Because that makes the dynamic, you know, it's kind of like, okay, I'm going to walk, chew bubble gum, jump rope, you know what I mean?
But you know
shoot
what?
Laser, you know, you got all these.
You know what's crazy
things.
Is that we've been doing that, though. Yeah. Like, and I think that for us, it doesn't seem so unnatural. Okay. Because we've been, like, before the pandemic hit and everybody had, kid was at home for school, we were doing that for already. At least 5 years before then.
Yeah, we've
you know?
Always homeschooled. We don't know what it's like to have our kids really in school. Past, like, two, three, they were in Montessori school really early, and then after that, they came home, and so we've always had them home. We've always worked with them around us, and we've always homeschooled them, so they have a schedule, and
get some of that okay. scenery. You gotta get some of that scenery out.
Oh, yes.
I'm sorry, keep talking though.
So we have a schedule. I gotta show you guys the scenery in Miami, because we're driving to work. This is what driving to work looks like. So we do have a schedule for them that we create, and then we do have things that we want to do when we get to different cities. Like, we have goals of things that we want to do. We want to find different things to do weekly, and things that are that cater to that local place wherever we're at, to make sure that we take advantage of everything local every time we travel. So there'll be different things like that. But other than that,
I think people really, I think there's a couple of questions underneath that question in terms of, like, do we have it mapped out? One, how are we doing it from a homeschool perspective? And then two, how are we doing it from, like, a business perspective? Like, how do we manage
and
all of
three,
that?
And number three, how are you going to do it? But I guess number three also, like I said, traveling from place to place in 30 days, right? 30-day increments or more, you know, in a shorter time frame. That is, you can do that by yourself, right? And that's really because you're kind of going with the flow. But we're talking about, you guys are creating a plan where you're having to do this with five personalities.
Well, if we, the plan is to make it, to have a process checking in and a process checking out.
Okay.
So everyone has a job. Mm-hmm. So that the check-in and the check-out of every place is very efficient.
Okay. That's
and
smart. Right?
We'll also have a checklist of everything that we have brought to the locations that we're leaving also with everything.
Awesome.
So there are different things logistically that we will have to put in place, that we will have in place to make sure that the parts of the process that are most, that can cause the most, I guess, anxiety. Grief and anxiety, because it is a lot of movement.
Yeah.
We're going to do as much as we can to mitigate it. But then at the same time, a big part of this process is just to learn how to have grace.
Ooh, I love that.
With just going with the universe and the spirit, and just not having control and just seeing where the universe is taking us. So there are going to be, which is a big part of homeschool, because we homeschool, but it's really unschooling.
Yeah.
We don't follow, like, public school structure. We create the structure that we want them to have. So that it really, really falls in line with it to have grace with ourselves in creating that structure and really understanding how we want our children to learn, because we had to unlearn what we've been taught as to how our children should learn, and then figure out a way of how we want them to learn.
Yeah.
So we've been running that madhouse for about 7 years now.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's also important to note that, like, our kids are probably not like other kids in terms of, like, their level of responsibility at our house. Like, my kids are already at 11 and 9, you know, both having cooked dinner, the full dinner for the family by themselves.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Like, everybody got responsibilities in this, you know what I mean? Like, and we've underscored, you know, going around and how this is going to be, like, we're removing the stability from our, you know, that we believe we have with the home. And
the
I say
house,
that
the
we,
house,
right the house
home.
Yeah with the house and I say that just like we, like people believe that you have security when they have
a
9-to-5 job.
Yeah.
Is I think we're challenging in some regard whether or not, you know, you're giving up stability because you're not in a particular location for extended period of time. And so, like, we've tried to talk about that with our kids as well and talk about that, hey, listen, things are gonna pop up. But they already live that kind of lifestyle. Mm-hmm. Like, my, you know, it's nothing for us to pick up now when we've been there and go and live in South Florida for 2 weeks and work from there. Like, or go to vacation in North Carolina and then make a stop in Atlanta for a week and then, you know, mosey on back down to Florida. Like, they, all three of our kids have already lived that life. Like, they know what that's like. They travel to, you know, when we've gone to conferences in New Orleans and we've driven from Florida to New Orleans and our kids have been in the car with us and gone. You know what I mean? Like, we've brought, right now we don't have a nanny, but we, at the time we had a nanny, and the nanny came with us, and they had their own activities and schedule, museums and stuff like that. So, you know, so in some regards, it's not even going to be that foreign
to them.
To them, you know, and that's why I think the core of our family, and like she said, the home, it's still going to travel with us, you know, everywhere we go, just like people now can work remotely and pick up and move that. Like, everywhere we go, we still have the same practices. We still sit down and eat dinner together.
Right.
You know what I mean? We still pray before together before we go to bed. We still, like, if we going somewhere, if we were driving down right now in the middle of the day and our kids had a class, which they do have classes, they would be on their tablet in class on the drive down. Okay. They've been through that before, so... so yeah, it's not so, I think the scariest part is just letting go.
Yeah.
It really is. And then just, you know, finding little ways to, create systems. I mean, my biggest anxiety is around my businesses, you know, but it's also caused me to speed up the process of putting other processes and systems in place to, you know, to automate things when I'm not, you know, able to do it in myself. But you know, that it's gonna be some bumps and challenges, but you know, our kids are pretty good with, you know, handling that type of stuff. So.
I'm excited.
Yeah, we are excited too. Royal Nomad.
If you like this video and you wanna see more of the Royal Nomads, hit that like button and subscribe down below.